2019-2020 academic year. We never envisioned that this was how our year would end. We thought that we would have been celebrating this momentous occasion at Grace Community Church with all our friends and family present. Instead, here we are in the open with masks on, social distancing. But that is not going to prevent us from celebrating with this grade 6 class in fine style. So without further ado, I'm going to ask that you remain seated as I welcome Genesis Academy's grade 6 class of 2020. They will be led by our Director of Academics, Dr. Lyric Knowles. Let's welcome our graduates. And our graduates are followed by our staff, our vice principal, and our principal. Eternal and everlasting God, as we come before you this evening, we just want to thank you that we are able to celebrate this milestone with our students as they step forward into new opportunities. We pray for the health and safety of those who are gathered here to celebrate with them, our staff, parents, family, and friends. Be with us now. Lead us, guide us, and direct us, we pray, in your precious and holy name. Amen. You may be seated. Our students have worked extremely hard to be where they are tonight, and they should be applauded. Help me welcome at this time the salutatorian, Evan Davis, with the welcome. Thank you.
our school's principal, Mrs. Melody Hanna, Vice Principal, Ms. Beryl Knowles, Director of Academic Affairs, Dr. Lyric Knowles, Master Teacher, Mrs. Kaylee Joaquin, Dean of Students, Pastor Leroy Hanna, teachers, especially Mrs. Julie Stewart and Ms. Chanel Carey, parents, family, friends, and to my fellow graduates, good evening. On behalf of the Genesis Academy, 6th grade graduating class of 2020, it is with great joy and pride that I welcome you to our graduation ceremony. We are extremely honored that you are here to celebrate this milestone with us, even in the midst of such challenging times for our country and the world around us. It is in these moments that life's greatest lessons may be learned. And we are here today because we all adapted and persevered. This evening, we are here to celebrate all of our hard work and achievements thus far on our educational journey. And believe me, it was a lot of hard work. I am extremely proud to be a part of this group of brilliant and competitive students. Therefore, in this moment of celebration, on behalf of my illustrious classmates, I say, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you, Evan. Hard work indeed. We are going to continue to celebrate their hard work and dedication. And at this time, coming to give the valedictorian speech is none other than Mr. John Godet III.
Good evening, everybody. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Distinguished guests, Principal Mrs. Melody Hanna, Vice Principal Ms. Beryl Knowles, Director of Academic Affairs Dr. Lyric Knowles, Master Teacher, Mrs. Kaylee Joaquin, Dean of Students, Pastor Leroy Hanna, teachers, parents, students, and fellow graduates, good evening. My name is John Godet III. On behalf of the 6th grade graduating class of 2020, I thank God that it was His plan for us to receive our primary education at Genesis Academy, the place where great minds truly begin. I started my first day at Genesis Academy at the age of 2, and not long after, most of my classmates here today joined as well. Eventually, more and more people started joining our class, and this grade 6 academic year was the only year in all of primary school that we did not have any new students join our class. Throughout the years, we have had awesome teachers. Our current homeroom teacher, Mrs. Julie Stewart, has been our teacher for every grade except for grade 4. We have had other great teachers such as Ms. Bain, Mrs. Fonseca, Mrs. Turnquist-Pointier, Ms. Knowles, Ms. Pratt, Ms. Burrows, Mr. and Mrs. Taylor, Ms. Francis, Ms. Carey, Ms. Williams, Mrs. Wright, and Coach Hernandez. We want to thank you all for being such amazing and hardworking teachers who have molded us into the students we are today. Consequently, great teachers also made for great times and experiences. And one of my favorite things about Genesis, and I think grade 6 will agree, is that Genesis has a lot of fun days and activities, like sports day, Christmas production, word parade, and Christmas decorating day. This sports day was a little earlier than usual, but still just as fun. One of my favorite parts was when Alex and I went head-to-head on the 400-meter race. We both gave it our all, and it was no doubt a photo finish. During Christmas time, we have the Christmas production and also Christmas decorating day. At Christmas production, we always have a bunch of fun practicing the lines and acting out our parts for the play. During Christmas decorating day, we decorate both our classroom and our trees. One of the greatest things about having a huge class is that as long as everybody brings at least one thing, we have a bunch of treats and sweets to eat. This decorating day, we decided to make gingerbread houses instead of cookies. And my house is still at home in a glass tray. At least most of it. Another fun and exciting event is Word Parade. And this year was even more exciting than the years before it. The grade 6 class got to perform all popular songs from music groups from the 60s because it was our last Word Parade. And at the Word Parade, we make cool costumes that match our selected word. Even the teachers get to make a costume. Then we all go on stage to show everybody watching. I really wish they had Word Parade in high school. We also have a club called Early Acts, where we raise money in order to help our community and others around the world. We normally do a hurricane relief project to help those in need. This project is so big that the whole school helps out. Grade 6 is so involved in Early Acts that we make up the whole board. We love to give back to the community. Each person in this class is special and unique in their own way, and have made this journey so enriching. Starting with Logan, who is the math king, and Alex, who is smart and full of surprises. Then there's Tatiana, who's a complex mix of someone who is playful and hardworking, and Evan, who is competitive in both academics and athletics. We also have Asan, who always pays attention in class and is prepared for any test or quiz. Matthew is well-rounded, Michael is tall and funny, and Caleb always cheers us up when we're down. Then we have Hunter and Leah, who are the best artists in our class and in all of primary school, if you ask me. Najee pushes us to be our best, and Miguel uses his talents to help us in sports and academics. Next is Ethan, who is quick on the track and in class. And last but not least, we have Nathan, who always gives his all to help his team or class succeed. They have all played an important part in helping us become the people we are today. Our class is a very close, tight-knit group, and we really support each other. Although we are all smart and competitive, we always remember to show love and respect for one another. We are hardworking, productive, and we never gave up. Year after year, we gave our best. Despite the interruption of the COVID-19 pandemic this term, we all rose to the challenge and ended the year strong. Like me, some of my classmates have been here since pre-kindergarten, so we are tried and true products of Genesis Academy's dynamic curriculum. We are well prepared to enter high school, and with our principal's motto, to go with God, we are ready for life's journey. We would like to say a special thank you to the teachers and staff who worked even harder this term because of the pandemic. No matter what, they made sure we were learning and that it was fun and engaging. They provided us with all the tools to succeed. Thank you to all our primary school teachers over the years, and especially to Miss Julie Stewart and Miss Chanel Carey, two really tough, no-nonsense, loving, caring, and concerned teachers. My class and I would also like to thank our parents and family who encouraged us to be the best, the smartest, studious, and most fun-loving class we are today. You supported us and always willingly sacrificed your time and money for our education and well-being. The least we can do, my fellow graduates, is to work hard, to be the best and make them proud. That is exactly what we intend to do. Right, graduates? Our foundation at Genesis Academy was first rate in education, but more importantly, Genesis Academy has taught us that our faith in God is our armor for life, and we are full of hope, confident that with God, all things are possible. Thank you, Genesis and parents, for loving us, and thank you for all you do. Good evening.
Thank you, Mr. Godet. I'm very proud. Can you see the pride on me? Very proud. Thank you. No institution is complete without a great leader. And at this time, we're going to call on our principal, Mrs. Melody Hanna, with the principal's address.
What an awesome night. What an awesome night. If you think this is an awesome night, say yeah. Yeah. All right. Okay, let me begin by giving first praise to the Almighty God for the great things He has done. We are not living in the best of times now, but God remains great. We are still battling COVID-19. Many are without jobs, and even though the economy is steadily opening up, great uncertainty looms around the future and what will happen next. Still, I place my trust in the Almighty God to bring us through these perilous times. As I look upon the high school class, as I look upon the elementary class of 2020, and you came here to cheer our graduates on, and I look upon the dynamic teachers who stayed the course and performed their duties despite COVID-19, I can attest that notwithstanding the times, Almighty God has been gracious and merciful to us. We must praise Him, for we are all still here today. I wish to congratulate the sixth grade class of 2020 for this milestone achieved. It is important, for the foundation you have set will impact the rest of your life. As graduations go, yours will always be the special because you have served as witnesses to what I'm sure will register as one of the biggest crises of the 21st century. Take personal notes, for each of you are now fully qualified COVID-19 pandemic historians. 40 years from now, many of you will be grandparents. Perhaps one day you will be invited to address the class of 2066 on the great pandemic. You will not need to refer to the history book. You will simply say, I was there. It is no small task to be given the responsibility of being the primary channel through which a child begins their formal education. This is the real power of preschool, kindergarten, and elementary school. Because so much can go wrong in these formative years, we are committed to the highest standards of academic, social, environmental, and of course, spiritual care for your child. This holistic approach to education has been the driving force of Genesis Academy since our inception in 2006. Thank you for entrusting your children to our care, and I am confident everyone will feed on the nutrition that builds strong minds, strong foundations, and strong characters. Your children possess right now everything they need to blast off. Parents, I'm sure, if nothing else, this pandemic has given you a deeper appreciation for the teaching profession. When the pandemic hit, Genesis Academy hit the ground running. For the past 6 years, our teachers have been training in online and blended learning teaching approaches. Though costly, we sought to partner with leaders in the field, and over these years, we have hosted a number of workshops. Our teachers are currently enrolled in courses to learn how to continuously build on online, build online content and effectively use learning management systems to support student learning and foster autonomy. We continuously upgrade our technical infrastructure to remain current and function as a 21st century learning environment. Parents, if you appreciated the lightning speed and professionalism with which our teachers performed during this pandemic, I please ask you to stand and give them a grand round of applause. Thank you, parents. I extend hearty congratulations to our parents. Teaching is not easy. Indeed, it is very demanding. So I thank you for the stellar job you did in partnering with us during this unprecedented time. I also wish to recognize the outstanding jobs of our custodians who keep our campus clean and sanitized. And I am so proud of the exceptional job of our business office under the keen leadership of our operations manager, Mr. Giorgio Knowles, assisted by Ms. Imana Fonseca. Ms. Julie Stewart, would you please stand? I wish to acknowledge your gifted administration and leadership skills in leading our elementary online learning. Your leadership has truly lightened my load. Please give Mrs. Stewart a round of applause for a job well done. Every year I have presented the principal's message in a video summary. Unfortunately, with time constraints imposed upon us by the pandemic, we could not deliver our usual video presentation. However, I will be sure to provide the video in the fall. Usually at this point, I speak to the graduates, but tonight I wish to change course and speak to you, our parents. It is very nerve-wracking when in an airplane, 36,000 feet above the ground, and the captain speaks with his loud voice, "Ladies and gentlemen, our radar is showing some rough weather ahead. And for your comfort and safety, we need you to fasten your seatbelts. For your comfort, we will do our best to fly around the weather, but please keep your seatbelts firmly fastened until the captain has turned off the fastened seatbelt sign." I am happy to be on this beautiful flight tonight. This is a great place to be on the journey. But I wish to say, fasten your seatbelts. Rough weather is ahead. I say this because you may soon experience a very turbulent period of your child's life. That period of pre-adolescence going to adolescence. It is that time when dependence is in an all-out war with independence. It's your final opportunity to have an indelible effect on the direction of your children. To get your children safely through this journey of life, you're going to need some tools. Turn on the evening news, and you will soon discover your children are growing up in a highly diverse and complicated world in every sphere of reality, political, morally, religiously, economically, philosophically, and every other lee is upon them. The isms and schisms and prisms, and all seeking to infiltrate and populate the minds of our children. So parents, you need to be a filter. Filter what they hear, filter what they see and believe, and ultimately filter their attitudes and behaviors. I encourage you to continue disciplining and training. Training must be intentional. A pilot does not go on a plane, take off, and hopes he arrives at his destination. His file is filled with a flight plan and with the destination in mind. As your principal, I see too many parents flying without a flight plan. You are like the archer shooting his arrow without aim, but hoping it will hit his target. Now let's be very clear. Even with a clear plan, like the airplane, the child will land somewhere. They may land in the middle of the ocean or in a jungle. But pause for a moment. Think about the child God invested to you. Do you think when he said train up a child, he saw the job as casual or as a duty you can dismiss or incontinent? Training requires remodeling and modeling. What you do, how you act, the choices you make, the way you respond to both crisis and blessings, the way you respond to authority, the way you respond as authority, in other words, the way you treat others, will be significant to this crucial stage of their development. For it is through modeling that a child learns not only what to do, but how to do. Perhaps the most distressing cry a parent can make is, "Oh my Lord, how my child get like this?" Finally, I encourage you to procure your child's faith. Help them to develop the kind of faith that informs them that no matter of the times, God is their refuge and their strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Help them to praise God in good times and to trust him in bad times. This is a fragile stage for your children, so fasten your seatbelts, follow the instructions of the captain, and you will get to the destination God has planned for your life. I will continue to pray for you, and I need you more than ever now to pray for me. My dear students, I know it doesn't appear so, but I turned 60 in January. I went to update my national insurance card only to discover that I am now officially a senior citizen. Can you believe it? Actually, it really worked out for me during this pandemic because I got to jump the line. I also need you to remember Genesis Academy. Please, speak well of us. We look forward to you coming back, helping us grow, and investing in us, and to be a continuing part of our legacy. So as you set upon your journey, make us proud. Deport yourselves like a person from a place where great minds begin.
For the moment you've all been waiting on, the presentation of certificates and trophies. I invite Miss Julie Stewart, the grade 6 homeroom teacher, to the stage, along with Mrs. Hanna and Dr. Knowles. Please welcome them.
Grade 6, are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's try that again. Grade 6, are you ready?
Yeah.
Ready or not, here we go. All right, listen up as it gives just a few instructions tonight. I am going to read the awards in alphabetical order, except for the last two, for our salutatorian and valedictorian. And after reading each award, we will invite the parents of each student to come and take a picture with them right here to my right, your left, and I will call you after your child has received the award. Just a parent, Pastor Hanna reminds me. Back row, can you please stand? We are going to begin first with Logan Arlen Bethel. Logan is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, and Science. He ends his final term with the Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention, and he receives the Yearly Honor Roll Award. Logan aspires to become a Major League Baseball player, and his life verse is taken from Matthew 7:12. Therefore, whatever you desire for men to do to you, you shall also do to them, for this is the law and the prophets. Ladies and gentlemen, Logan Arlen Bethel. I would like to invite Pastor Lyle Bethel and Mrs. Bethel to come to the front to take pictures with Logan. Next up, let's invite Alexander Fidel Bronlick. Alex is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Math and Teacher's Effort for Creative Writing. His special award is the Citizenship Award, and he is a member of Genesis G-Force basketball team. He ends this final term with the Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention and receives the Yearly Honorable Mention Award. Alex intends to become a law enforcement officer. His life verse is taken from Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Ladies and gentlemen, Alexander Fidel Bronlick. I would like to invite Alex's parents to the front to take pictures with him. Next up, we have Tatiana Perline Burrows. Tatiana is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Social Studies, Math, and Science. She receives special awards for Teacher's Effort for Spanish, Most Outstanding Female Physical Education and Sports, the Citizenship Award, the Most Helpful Award. She is a member of the Early Act Club, a member of the G-Force Volleyball Team, and Girls Basketball Team. She ended the spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the Yearly Honor Roll Award. Tatiana intends to pursue the arts and become a life fitness coach. Her life verse is taken from Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Ladies and gentlemen, Tatiana Perline Burrows. I invite Tatiana's parents to come and take pictures with her. Next, let's invite Hassan Arthur William Gibson. Hassan is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Social Studies, Math, and Science. He receives special awards for Teacher's Effort for Reading Comprehension and Social Studies, the Most Compassionate Award, the Citizenship Award, and the Christian Character Award. He is the recording secretary of the Early Act Club. He ended the spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the Yearly Honor Roll Award. Hassan aspires to become an electrical engineer. His life verses are taken from Lamentations 3:22-23. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Ladies and gentlemen, Hassan Arthur William Gibson. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Gibson to come and take pictures with Hassan. Next up, let's welcome Matthew Alexander Gomez. Matthew is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Math, and Spanish. He receives special awards for Most Improved Reading Comprehension, the Christian Character Award, the Citizenship Award, Leadership Award, and Most Outstanding Spanish. He is the treasurer of the Early Act Club and the captain of the G-Forces basketball and volleyball teams. He ended the spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the Yearly Honor Roll Award. Matthew aspires to become a professional basketball player. His life verse is taken from Deuteronomy 28, verse 13. The Lord will make you the head, not the tail. If you pay attention to the commands of the Lord, your God, that I give you this day, and carefully follow them, you will always be on top, never at the bottom. Ladies and gentlemen, Matthew Alexander Gomez. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Gomez to the front. Next up, we have Michael Andrew Nathan Longley. Michael is receiving the Graduates Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible and Math. He is a member of the Genesis G-Force volleyball team. He ends this year with the yearly Honorable Mention Award. Michael aspires to become a comedian. His life verse is taken from Matthew 5:16. Let your light shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Andrew Nathan Longley. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Longley to the front to take pictures with Michael. Next up, let's welcome Caleb Ira Pete. Caleb is receiving the Graduates Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Math, Science, and Spanish. Caleb is the corresponding secretary of the Early Act Club, and he receives a special certificate as a member of the Discovery Club. He ends this final term with the Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention and receives the yearly Honorable Mention Award. Caleb aspires to become a professional swimmer. His life verse is taken from 1 John 4:7-8. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who is loved is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Ladies and gentlemen, Caleb Ira Pete. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Pete to the front to take pictures with Caleb. Next, let's welcome Hunter Shylock Scout Ramsey. Hunter is receiving the Graduates Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Math, and Science. His special award is the Citizenship Award. Hunter is the Assistant Sergeant at Arms of the Early Act Club. He ends this final term with the Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention and receives the yearly Honor Roll Award. Hunter aspires to become an artist, and his life verse is taken from Psalms 118, verse 6. The Lord is on my side, I will not fear. Ladies and gentlemen, Hunter Shylock Scout Ramsey. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Ramsey to the front. Next up, let's welcome Najee Amare Saunders. Tonight, Najee is receiving the Graduates Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Social Studies, Math, and Science. He receives a special award for Most Improved Bible, tied for Most Outstanding Bible, and the Citizenship Award. Najee is a member of the Early Act Club, and he aspires to become a marine biologist. He ended the spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the yearly Honor Roll Award. His life verse is taken from Proverbs 17:22. A cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. Ladies and gentlemen, Najee Amare Saunders. I invite Mr. and Mrs. Saunders to take pictures with Najee. Back row, you may be seated. Front row, stand please. Next up, let's welcome Miguel James Smith. Miguel is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, and Math. He receives special awards for Teacher's Effort in Science and the Citizenship Award. He is a member of the Genesis G-Force basketball team. Miguel aspires to become a professional tennis player. He ends this final term with the Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention and receives the yearly Honorable Mention Award. His life verse is taken from Matthew 6:33. But seek ye first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Miguel James Smith.
Help me welcome Ethan Stort. Ethan is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and the Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Language Arts, Social Studies, Math, and Science. He received special awards for Most Outstanding Social Studies and tied for Most Outstanding Male Physical Education and Sports Award, the Leadership Award, and the Christian Character Award. Ethan is the head chair of the Earlier Club and receives a special certificate as a member of the Discovery Club. He is also a member of the Genesis's G-Force volleyball and basketball teams. He ended spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the yearly Honor Roll Award. Ethan aspires to become an aviator. His life verse is taken from Psalms 23, verse 6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Ladies and gentlemen, Ethan Stort. And we invite his parents for your photograph. Nathan Nicholas Sumner. Nathan is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Math, and Science. He received special awards for the Teacher's Effort in Math, Teacher's Effort in Language Arts, and the Most Improved Creative Writing. Nathan is a Sergeant at Arms of the Early Act Club. He ends this final term with a Bronze Seal for Honorable Mention. He receives the yearly Honorable Mention Award. Nathan aspires to become a lawyer or a support technician. His life verse is taken from Ephesians 4, verse 32. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave us. Ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Nicholas Sumner. Leah Violet Rose Thompson. Leah is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Math, and Science. She receives a special award for the Most Improved Social Studies. Leah is a member of the Early Act Club. She ended the spring term with the Silver Seal for Honor Roll and receives the yearly Honor Roll Award. Leah aspires to become an artist. Her life verse is taken from Matthew 7, verse 12. Therefore, whatever you desire for men to do to you, you shall also do to them. For this is the law and the prophets. Ladies and gentlemen, Leo Violet Rose Thompson.
We invite Mr. and Mrs. Thompson to come take pictures with Leo. Help me welcome our salutatorian, Evan Ryan Davis. Evan is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Creative Writing, Reading Comprehension, Language Arts, Social Studies, Math, Science, and Spanish. He receives special awards for Most Outstanding Math, tied for Most Outstanding Bible, the Leadership Award, the Early Act Vice President's Award, and the First Runner-Up Student of the Year Award. Evan ended the spring term with the gold seal for the Principal's Honor Roll and receives the yearly Principal's Honor Roll Award. Evan aspires to become a computer hardware engineer. His life verse is taken from Psalms 119, verse 160. Thy word is true from the beginning, and every one of thy righteous judgments endureth forever. Ladies and gentlemen, the sixth grade 2020 salutatorian, Evan Ryan Davis. Congratulations. We invite the parents of Evan to come and take pictures with him. Now, ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome our valedictorian, John Alexander Gadet III. John is receiving the Graduate's Trophy and Subject Awards for Bible, Language Arts, Creative Writing, Reading Comprehension, Science, Social Studies, Math, and Spanish. He receives special awards for Most Improved Language Arts, Most Outstanding Reading Comprehension, Most Outstanding Language Arts, Most Outstanding Creative Writing, Most Outstanding Science, tied for Most Outstanding Male, Physical Education and Sports. He receives the Christian Character Award, the Leadership Award, and the School Spirit Award, a special award for President of the Early Act Club, and the 2020 Genesis Academy Student of the Year Award. He is a member of the Genesis G-Force volleyball and basketball teams. He ended the spring term with the gold seal for the Principal's Honor Roll and receives the yearly Principal's Honor Roll. John aspires to become a professional sports player, coach, and mentor. His life verse is taken from Deuteronomy 31, verse 6. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Ladies and gentlemen, the sixth grade 2020 valedictorian, John Alexander Gadet III. We invite Mr. and Mrs. Gadet to come and take pictures with John. We have one more award, and Dr. Knowles will announce that.
Good evening. We have one final special award that we are giving tonight, and this award is in honor of Miss Lucille Bassett. And Mrs. Bassett was a teacher with Genesis Academy for many years. A beautiful person, a wonderful teacher, a wonderful soul. And so tonight, in her honor, we would like to present the Lucille Bassett Fine Arts Award to John Gadet III.
While he takes his picture, I just want to say thank you, parents, for choosing Genesis Academy and granting us the opportunity to work with your children. Grade 6, it has been an extreme pleasure and honor to have taught you in some capacity from grade 1 to present. I'm extremely proud of the work and you have done this year, especially, and I want to commend you for how you persevered during our pandemic. Especially in the last term, you transitioned very well to virtual learning. Even though it wasn't easy, you excelled. I want to remind you to pursue excellence, never give up, work hard, and most importantly, put God first. As Miguel's life verse said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and whatever else you want will be added to you. Finally, as our principal said, go out and do great things. as you came from the place where great minds begin. Thank you. Good evening. Front row, you may be seated. Team. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of our program. At this time, I'm going to invite Pastor Lal Bethel, father of one of our graduates, Logan Bethel, who will pray for our graduates and also close us out tonight with our benediction. Please welcome Pastor Lal.
As the only parent on the program, exclusive of Mrs. Stewart, I really want to say to Genesis Academy, the principal, the dean, all of the students and staff, phenomenal job. I mean, you didn't miss a beat. COVID-19 hit. You guys just dropped right in stride. And all of us as parents learned about Zoom. If you didn't know about Zoom before, you learned about Zoom as a result. I'm just going to quickly take a picture of you guys, if you don't mind. And of course, these awesome graduates. On behalf of the parents, I wish to congratulate all of you. Great job. We've enjoyed watching you become friends and God develop your talents as the teachers and the sports and everything. God is really, God's creativity has been on display through you. And I'm so grateful for what I've been seeing tonight. And I thank God for every one of you. And I trust we're going to see all of you go straight up through the school. And we as parents will become even better friends than we've been before. And we thank God for it all. All right, I've taken up too much of my time before I pray. Let's look to the Lord in prayer, shall we? Heavenly Father, we stand amazed. We've always known that you are a creative God. We look at the skies, the trees, the flowers, and we see your great creativity. But Lord, tonight what we have seen is that each of these young souls, you've given and put in them, you've imparted into them gifts, talents, skills, creativity. And we thank God for this school and the teachers that working with them have drawn forth their various skill sets and talents. And they've rightly been rewarded this evening for their teachers, for the principal, staff, even those who keep the grounds. We thank you for the excellence of this school, that rightly so we've seen this is a place where great minds begin and develop. We thank you for every home represented here, and we pray that as we go into a strange summer, we've never had a summer like this before, with COVID-19 and all that it means, all the possibilities of vacationing gone. And so there's a need for creativity with us as parents to figure out how are we going to harness these great minds for the summer. But Lord, we pray that working together, we can add to the learning that they've received. And as we return back to this place for the next school term, all would have been benefited. And that despite the times we're in, we will see students ready and alert to begin a new school term and more of their creative talents brought to bear. Bless them, Lord. May your favor and grace follow them all the days of their life. Keep them, Lord, from making decisions that would be harmful to their spiritual, emotional, and moral health. Give them wisdom, Lord, to live right and to be a good example to their fellow classmates, a joy to their parents, and a great contributor to our society at large. This is a prayer we make in Christ's name. And now our benediction. now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Bless us, Lord, as we leave this place. Take us with your benediction and graces. And as we move into celebration, may we not forget to give you the glory and thanks for what you have shown today. Gifts and talents brought to bear because of your gracious hand of mercy in each life. We pray in Christ's name. Amen. Bless you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Genesis Academy Grade 6 Class of 2020. Thank you for joining us and have a great summer. Good evening. We're asking the graduates to remain on